Hello, everyone. My name is Siyoung Ri, and I'm from the Advanced Analytics team in CNE. The purpose of this MTC0 video is to help showcase how Microsoft Business Analytics and AI can help a customer transform their business processes. The fundamental customer challenge of how you get actionable insights from your data has not changed. However, in the last few years, we've seen significant trends impact our ability to leverage data to accelerate business. The cloud now enables elastic compute and storage at low cost. The availability of new types of data from sensors, devices, social platforms, and third-party sources allows us to better predict outcomes. The sudden growth and popularity of AIs is enabling new scenarios. This is a direct outcome of the availability of large volumes of data and the ability to store at low cost. The convergence of these trends, cloud, big data, and AI, is accelerating the pace at which companies can transform their business processes. They're finding new ways to engage customers, empower employees, optimize operations, and transform products. In this demo, we will show you how an insurance company can leverage business analytics and AI to fundamentally transform the way they do customer service and reduce churn. We are going to walk through three scenarios. First, is how customers can interact with solution via personalized conversations automated with bots. And second, is how the customer service support agent gets benefits from machine learning and analytics to predict and minimize churn. And finally, is how the VP of operations can monitor global activity through real-time dashboards and take action. Gianpaolo, please take us through the demo.
Hello everyone, my name is Gianpaolo Battaglia, and now I will present the demonstration starting as a customer. In this example, I've just purchased a new car and I'm looking for an insurance quote. I happen to be at an event outside and I don't have access to my laptop, so I could directly call for assistant or start a chat on my mobile app. Let's take a look at it. Now, we're in the insurance app. Bots can support many different patterns of interactions. For example, bots are multilingual. I can say bonjour, like this, and see the response in my language of choice. So no more dialing one for English, two for Spanish, and even three for French. Then I can ask the bot a simple question, like, where are you located? Like that. Here, I'm switching back in English, and two things are happening. It's identifying that I switched in English language, and I'm getting an immediate response as it's able to identify the intent of the question regardless how I phrase it. So now, let's type. The bot will understand the intent and ask me for which type of insurance I'm looking for. It can be property, life, but let's select automotive. As you can see, it's not only text-based, but rich content embedded in the chat window. It's asking if I'm an existing customer now. I will select yes. And of course, it's asking authentication part, my name, and my PIN. Today my name is Lens Olsen. And personal identification number. In addition to using a PIN, I could also authenticate using my face or even my voice recognized. Also, because it's integrated with Dynamics CRM, we're able to connect to business processes and retrieve customer information. As you can see now, the image has been changed with the face. Using information from the CRM system, the bot is now able to identify that I've got a daughter who's born in 2000. She just turned 16, and she might be added to my policy, which I decide to accept. Yes. So think about these upsell scenario opportunities there. Next, I need to provide additional information related to the car I just bought. What's the make of the car? And what is the model? And the year. And we'll select 2015. Now, I'm asked to provide a picture of the car, as a baseline picture is critical for insurance companies, especially if you have an accident. So let me upload a picture right now. But as I have dumb thumbs, I'm going to select not the right car image. But this is interesting because thanks to computer vision and deep learning capabilities, the system can understand what is inside an image and verify if the content is appropriate. That doesn't look like a car, it looks more Daniel Radcliffe on a stage to me. In the future, think about what we could do with these deep learning techniques. You'd be even able to upload a picture of your car and have the system automatically recognize the brand and the model. Now, I'm putting a real car. Here we are. Nice purchase. Now, in the background, the system is pulling together all the information provided. Past purchase history, driving records, and other relevant data to generate an optimized offer. You can see now that the price is $146.50 per month. Lastly, the bot is now asking what I think about this. Of course, I could say, yes, it's perfect, but let's see what happens if I respond negatively. I think this is very expensive. The system detects the negative sentiment of my response and starts a warm handoff to a live customer representative. I'm now going to hand off to Siyoung, the customer service agent.
Okay, I'll play the role of the customer service agent here, and this is what I see. Now the bot, in addition to helping the customer, has also created a CRM opportunity for me. In Dynamics CRM, I can see the customer's basic profile information, such as their name, when they have their licenses, their dependents, and also the vehicle profile they're trying to insure. In addition, the bot is also helping me, the customer agent, by giving me specific suggestions on how best to deal with this opportunity. For example, you can see how the bot has escalated to the agent. It also has things like, according to my churn prediction model, it is offering a 10% discount as well as the churn prediction rate. In addition, in the CRM window, we also have the history that the bot has chatted with the customer, as you can see here. The various photos, the profile information that the customer and the bot had interacted with. Finally, if I look at the products the customer has already bought, the system has also recommendations based on embedded machine learning capabilities in Dynamics 365. For example, I can look at some of the suggestions that the system is recommending that I can offer to the customer. Now, this interacting is an example of one customer and one agent. Imagine thousands of these interactions happening simultaneously around the world and every event being stored in a data lake or a data warehouse. The VP of operations, who sponsored this new system, now has access to a view and status of all the chats and interactions happening globally. I'm now going to hand off to Gianpaolo, our new VP of operations.
Thank you, Siyoung. As I am now the VP of operations, I have access to real-time dashboards of all my events happening globally. Let's take a look. For example, I can see the number of real-time chats with the objectives, but also the real-time happening. I can also take a look at the business which has been generated today, the number of escalations, as well as the global satisfaction which is analyzed. And I can also double-click to see the real-time customer satisfaction among the different channels. By scrolling down, I can also see my chat performance with the funnel of engagement between the active chats, the one successfully landing, the one which needed escalation, and the one where customers decided to leave the service. I can also see the cost to serve, but we can also have a view of the number of chatbot sessions evolving over time, and we see that they're increasing. And two additional very interesting KPIs. The average time session with the bots in yellow, we can see that it's increasing, maybe because it wasn't answering the right answers. And by tuning it, we realize that then the average time decreased. And the other element in purple is the average time session with a real human agent. And this is a very important KPI, considering that we need to reduce it as much as possible. The last interesting element is related to the customer churn over time, in which you can see the actual churn without human intervention, which is rising, and the one with intervention, which is decreasing. Because this is text-based chat, we can even do sentiment and topic extraction and express it as a word cloud. Let's look at what's happening in the global activity on the map. For example, we can see worldwide that the performance is okay, but something seems to be unusual in Australia. I realize that we've got a red circle there, and if we click on it, we can quickly see why. I see that Contoso Insurance, our major competitor, and the word expensive emerge in the key phrases extracted. I call my local representative to ask what's going on, and I learn that Contoso Insurance has lowered their prices aggressively. I now can take immediate action to be price competitive in that market.
Thanks, Gianpaolo. To summarize, in this solution, business analytics and AI helped me deepen my customer engagement, predict outcomes, and helped reduce churn. Also, this helped automate actions by allowing my VP of operations to make real-time adjustments to competitive price pressures. Everything you saw here was built by two developers in a month, using our business analytics and AI capabilities in the cloud. The view here is a simple behind-the-scenes view to explain how the services come together to accelerate transformation. All of this was built using Cortana Intelligence Services and Dynamics 365. This is just one example of how business analytics and AI can help transform the business process for an organization. We have customers across every industry with similar stories for transformation. For example, Rockwell, a global industrial automation company, cut development time by 80% and costs up to 90% by providing full-time pipeline visibility. Or QuarterSpot, a startup in the financial sector who lowered loan defaults by 50%, leading to increased profitability. So with that, we'd like to conclude today's video. Thanks for watching.